Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hi, all my favorite cameraholics. We have a new beer in town. No, I mean a new camera in town. Something for us to drool over and salivate and make us go, I want that. I got to have it. Right? Okay, everybody stand up and say, my name is Peter Gregg. Of course, fill in your name. And I am a cameraholic. Every time the camera company gives us a new camera, I must buy it. Okay, so what do we got new in town? It's the new Sony A9. Sony A9. Wow. So what is the Sony A9 all about? It's got so much stuff. I wrote it down so this way I don't make a mistake. You know, a mistake? Different from a Mr. Steak. You should have a steakhouse called Mr. Steak. Anyway, it's a 24 megapixel back illuminated full frame CMOS sensor. Do you know what that means? When they say back illuminated, they go BSI, back illuminated. Well, there's pixels, and there's one pixel next to another pixel next to another pixel next to another pixel until you got all these pixels lined up, right? Then you got another row. Well, all the information that comes from these pixels, where does it go? They goes to the next pixel. Well, how are they all tied together? They put a little piece of wire between them, so it separates the pixels. Well, if you take all that wiring and you put it on the back side, so this way, instead of the wire going from one to the other like a chain, it goes out the back. And all the wiring that you see on the board for the sensor is on the back side. They call that backside illuminated because the pixels are illuminated and all the information, the light that comes in, goes to the back of it. Now they could take the pixels that were that far apart and move them and butt them up against each other. So 24 megapixel backside illuminated. I'm sure you didn't want to know all that information, but what it does is it allows for the pixels to be closer, and because of that, it allows the pixels to be bigger. Bigger pixels gives us lower noise. Aha, well, there is an advantage. It shoots 20 frames per second into RAW frames or JPEG frames, 20 frames a second. I'm shooting on the Panasonic GH5 right now at 24 frames per second. So can you imagine how many images that's going to be? That's amazing. The shutter is completely silent because it's an electronic shutter, but it does have artificial sound available. So if you want that sound, all you got to do is turn it on and it'll play it out the speaker of the camera. Wow, how cool is that, right? Not cool at all, so don't get excited. The good part is it's got 5-axis in-body image stabilization. The Canon 5D Mark II, excuse me, the 5D, the Canon 1DX Mark II, which is Canon's flagship high-end sports camera, doesn't have image stabilization built into the camera, neither does the Nikon D5. So another big plus, we've got big pluses going around the board here. Plus, it'll allow you to zoom 2x, like a 2x zoom, with no image stabilization from the same millimeter. So if you put a 50 millimeter, you can zoom it out to 100 millimeter, all inside the camera, and you won't have any image loss. It'll focus down to -3 in lighting, which not quite as good because the other ones are -4, which is like double the light. the 4K stream tops out at 30p, and it is a 6K image that's downsampled in the camera to 4K. So it's going to give you a little bit of a crop. Probably 1.3, which is a very much like an APS-H. Remember the APS-H size? You don't remember the APS-H size? Remember when there was a Canon 1D Mark II and then the Canon 1D Mark IIN? It wasn't full frame, but it wasn't the crop sensor. It was in between at 1.3. This is going to be something similar to that. Okay, where were we here? It's got dual card slots. Yes, and one of them has the new, it's in the camera, SD card that goes at super duper high speeds, which is very important. And one of the biggest complaints on the Sony cameras is the batteries weren't big enough. You'd shoot three pictures, gotta change the battery. Shoot three more pictures, gotta change the battery. So there's a joke, that's not true, okay? It has like 150, 200 images, but the battery strength is a weakness of it, especially when you're running videos. But there's a joke that says, you know how you could pick out a Sony guy? He's the one with the vest that's got batteries all the way up and down, like in 12 rows. His whole vest is like battery. It's like bulletproof because of the batteries. That's pretty funny. So it has a flip-out screen, but it's not articulating. It's got a native ISO from 100 to 51,000. This one's an important one for me. The spot metering will follow the spot focusing. So how simple is that? But Canon won't do that except for the 1DX Mark II. So the 1DX Mark II has it, but the 5D Mark IV doesn't have it. Now on the Canon side, on the Nikon side, the Nikon 5D5 has that. But then so does the D810. And so does the D800E and the regular D800. And I think the 750. So that's important because you could have a lighting behind the subject and you need to get the face lit up properly because it's about the face. It's not like, whoa, what a nice elbow you have there, young man. No, it's about the face. So a spot metering that can link to the spot focus means wherever it is that you're gonna focus, kabam, you're in focus. Sony's claiming 14 stops of dynamic range. It's got a joystick, which is great because you can move that metering, the spot focus all the way around. It's got 693 sensor phase detection points. Wowzer, wowzer, that's a lot of phase detection points. We'll see if that pans out to be really good in autofocus. And the 5-image stabilization is going to supposedly give you 5 additional stops, meaning if you were going to shoot an f2.8, you can go f2, f1.8, f1.4, f1.2. You could just keep going and it'll help save the stabilization, but you do that on the shutter side. So if you were going to shoot in at 250th of a second, you can go to 1/200th, 1/180, 150, 125. It allows a slower shutter speed. And the shipping is supposed to be in May, which means June. So that's the specs of the camera. So I've been watching some videos. Max Yuryev has been showing some videos. Tony Northrup has been showing some videos. Who else has been out there? So many people. Now I can't even remember, and I'm gonna forget somebody, but. A lot of the big names are out there getting together and they're giving their experience. And then from there, they're gonna go into the National Association of Broadcasters, which where we get more information. So they're calling this the 1DX Mark II killer, the Nikon D5 killer. It's got all this neat stuff in it. It's $4,500. $4,500. Oh, wait, edit that part out. It's $4,500. $4,500. So when you take your credit card out, it's $4,500 plus tax, unless you buy it from B&H, and I'll put a link there, because if you're not in New York, you'll pay $4,500 without tax. But if you buy it on Amazon, guess how much it'll be? Go ahead, guess. Guess how much it'll be? It'll be $4,500, and for most of the country, plus tax. So the camera is definitely a step forward in technology. It's quite interesting. I'm going to be thinking about it, but right now it's very exciting, and I wanted to bring it to you guys so you can hear about it, know about it, go read about it, and I will give you my opinion about it after I've had 3 or 4 days to regurgitate the new camera, And all the good stuff. No, I don't drink beer. Actually, I don't like beer. So anyway, that's basically the show for today. I just wanted you to know about the A9. Actually, they had the what was the progression? I think it was an A900. Then they had the A99. These are flagships, and now they came out with the A9. Now the A9 is a full frame sensor compared to the 1DX Mark II, which is a full frame sensor, compared to the poor Nikon D5, which is a full frame sensor. Wow, that's something new, full frame sensors. So it is a full frame sensor, but when you go to shoot and video, it's going to be cropped a little bit, but it's going to crop the 6K down to 4K in the camera, so it's going to give you that very good quality Sony video image. So that's all the good stuff that I can think on the camera. I'm going to be watching, and then I'll come back in another video, and I will tell you what I really think about the camera. No, I'm just teasing. It's a technological breakthrough. It's something for Canon and Nikon to be looking at, how this one company is just giving all the goods, and the other two are giving some of the goods, and they're going, ooh, look at us. So anyway, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, thanks for watching. Please subscribe. I'm almost going to hit 19,000 subscribers. Yay, that's quite a thing in 3 or 4 years, coming up from 6 or 7,000. We're almost at 19. I was going to say 9,000. So thank you to all my new subscribers. I want you to know I appreciate you. I'm thankful. I'm grateful that you're here. And if you haven't subscribed and you're watching and you feel like pushing a button, because you know that urge comes every once in a while, like I got to push a button. I don't know what it is, but I just got to push a button. Hit the subscribe button. I would appreciate that. And you will too. All right. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, live from the Christmas room. Catch you later. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.
Okay, where's my jingle bells? Come here, baby. Come and say hello to everybody. They've been waiting to see you. Yes, they have. They've been waiting to see you. I wanted you to say hi to Jingles because he wanted to say hello to you. Oh, there he goes. He's laying down on the table. And tomorrow we're going to get our shots. Tomorrow morning we're going to get our shots. The doctor and the nurses, oh, they just love him to no end. But when he goes in, he starts trembling. He's so scared. He thinks, I don't know what he thinks, and I don't want to say anything bad, okay? But we go there, and he just starts trembling. So on the next video, he will have had his yearly shots, and he's going to get his checkup and all that kind of stuff. So I figured you want to say hello and tell him everything's going to be all right. See, everybody's telling you, it's going to be okay, Jingle Bells. It's going to be wonderful. Don't be afraid, okay? Okay, baby. All right, guys, that's it. Bye-bye. What's the matter?